Cells from the immune system patrol and protect the body against infections by viruses and bacteria. For many people, the immune system goes unnoticed. For others, defects in immune cells result in constant and damaging infections.
I was hospitalized from August to December every month. At least 2 weeks.
Brittany Melton is from Olin, North Carolina. Since early childhood, she suffered from endless infections, pneumonia, extensive warts, and lung difficulties. After exhausting all other options, she was referred to the National Institutes of Health, or NIH, in 2009. Brittany was diagnosed with DOCK8 deficiency, a rare immune disease. Researchers at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases, or NIAID, had just discovered the cause of DOCK8 deficiency, which was named after the affected gene. Alexandra Freeman is a clinician at NIAID and part of the team that diagnosed Brittany.
Most of the patients weren't surviving past, you know, either their teenage years or their 20s. So because of all that, we were looking for a better therapy and looked to bone marrow transplant.
The team tested bone marrow transplantation as a way to replace the defective immune cells of DOCK8 deficient patients, including Brittany.
I told mom that I could be a hand model now that I don't have warts anymore. Because they were pretty bad, you know. That was probably the coolest thing to see from the transplant. We actually got to see something get better.
Helen Sue is a researcher at NIAID and led the discovery behind DOCK8 deficiency.
We said, okay, maybe we can look for holes in patients' DNA and sort of see what was missing. If it was missing, maybe that might be contributing to some of the genetic diseases that people hadn't discovered.
NIH, home to the largest clinical research hospital in the world, accelerates health discoveries by bringing together patients, clinicians, and scientists.
A lot of the patients are actually relieved to actually have a name to put with what's going on and knowing that people are actually doing research on it. Even if we can't say, you know, we have a perfect cure right now, they're just happy that someone's actually focused on this and someone's doing research and someone has ideas and someone's going to follow up with them.
For DOCK8 deficient patients who are too sick for a bone marrow transplant, NIAID researchers are still searching for alternative therapies.
At the NIH, the patients are very special because they're very motivated to understand their disease. So they come here and we not only try to, as a whole team, to take care of them, but we also consider them to be partners in the research endeavors.
Coming here has changed everything. I finally got to where I wasn't coming every month. And they kind of celebrated that with me as well, that I didn't have to come back every month. So they want you well just as much as you want to be well.